हेलो, आई एम प्रशांत महाजन फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग, ऑल इंडिया श्री शिवाजी मेमोरियल सोसाइटीज इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी। दिस वीडियो इज इंटेंडेड टू अंडरस्टैंड द इंटरफेसिंग ऑफ ADC 0809 विद द माइक्रो कंट्रोलर 8051। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैड सीन द पिन लेआउट of 0809 IC, as well as we had seen the different control signals which are used for controlling ADC 0809. So this is the 28 pin IC for analog to digital conversion, and we had also seen the steps which we need to follow to read the value of ADC. So the next slide will show you the interfacing of ADC with 8051. Here we have used port 1 to read the digital outputs of ADC, and the control signals are given through port C. Now these are the control signals which are connected to port 2 of 8051. Address A, address B, address C are connected to P2.0, 2.1, 2.2. AL is connected to P2.4. OE is output enable pin, which is connected to P2.5. Start pin is connected to P2.6, and EOC is connected to P2.7. So if you can see, there are two pins, rather a port 1 is configured and needs to be configured as input port, and P2.7 pin is also configured as input pin. All the other pins are used as output pins. Now the steps which are required to read the value of ADC are: first, we need to select the analog input channel through the addresses. Then we need to activate ALE, that means we have to generate a pulse on ALE which will latch the address. Then we need to give a start pulse. So once you give the start pulse on the falling edge of start pulse, the ADC 0809 will start converting the analog quantity into digital format. Once the conversion is complete, which will take 8 clock pulses, it will raise a line which is EOC. So we have to keep monitoring EOC line, and when EOC becomes equal to 1, it indicates end of conversion. So once the conversion is complete, we'll enable the output enable pin, and once the output enable pin is made equal to 1, the converted data will be available on output pins of the ADC. So the C program for this is as shown over here. It is divided, I have divided into three parts. One is the delay which will require for generation of pulses, and this is a part wherein we declare the different port pins. So S bit address A, ADDR A is equal to P2.0. So instead of using P2.0, I'll be using its name, which is ADDRA. So similarly, all the control signals are assigned over here, and we have started the main program by configuring port 1 and EOC as input port and input pin. So P1 equal to 0xFF and EOC equal to 1. We'll configure pin P2.7 as input pin. Similarly, port 1 is configured as input port. Then ADDR A equal to 0, B ADDR B equal to 0, ADDR C equal to 0. So these three lines will select channel 1 of the ADC 0809. Next is we'll generate a delay. We'll generate a pulse on ALE. So ALE equal to 1, then call some delay, ALE equal to 0 again. We call it a delay. So this will generate a pulse on ALE, which will be used for latching up of addresses. Once the address is latched, we'll generate a pulse on the start pin. So SC pin is connected to P2.6, so we'll generate a pulse on that pin. So SC equal to 1, again delay, SC equal to 0 and a delay. So that pulse, on the falling edge of pulse, it will start converting analog quantity from channel 0 into its digital equivalent. Once the conversion is completed, it will raise an EOC. So we'll keep on checking EOC by this statement, while EOC equal to 0 semicolon, means if it is equal to 0, do nothing, you'll keep on looping in the same instruction till EOC is equal to 0. When EOC equal to 1, it means that the conversion is complete, it will come out of the loop. So we'll make OE, that is output enable pin, equal to 1. After making this output enable pin equal to 1, the converted data will be available on the output of the ADC, which is connected to port 1. So next statement is reading port 1. So ACC equal to P1 means the contents of port 1 are read or are copied to accumulator. So this program will give you an idea of how to read a value from an ADC. And the last statement is while 1 semicolon. So this program will be executed only once. So only the data from ADC will be read only once, and it will be kept into accumulator. For this, we'll require a short delay. So this is a delay subroutine which uses two for loops, and this will give you a delay in milliseconds. So delay 20 will pass on a variable 20 to pass on a number 20 to a variable time. So time will be equal to 20, and this program will generate a delay of 20 milliseconds. So this is as far as programming C is concerned to read a value of ADC 0809 using 8051. Thank you.